It's NBA action on EA Sports. I'm Ed Cohen. Great to be joined by Jay Williams for what should be a terrific matchup here tonight. We're at Pepsi Center in downtown Denver. Tonight, it's the Denver Nuggets playing host to the LA Clippers. Opening tip won by the Nuggets. They get it first as we're underway at the Pepsi Center. Stuffs it down with authority.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice finish. It's all business.
To George. Jay, upon scanning this Clippers roster, there are a lot of guards for Doc Rivers to work with.
Yeah, they have a plethora of guards, and if I'm this team and if I'm Doc Rivers, I'm thinking about how do I throw as many guards at you as possible, because Doc wants to get another guard in there to apply the same pressure. They should be the new modern-day Detroit Pistons with the style they play defensively.
Slams it down!
I don't know if the scouting report has made its way out here yet, but if anything, it says you need to not let him get that close to the rim.
Beverly into the front court. Down four. There's the toss. Nice pace. Sets it up and slams it down. Jay, when you break down Paul George, where is he at his best?
He needs to be engaged. He needs to have the ball in his hands. He needs to be needed. And that's the biggest thing for Paul George. When he's the guy offensively and he makes those clutch shots, it re-engages him defensively. And that drives him to be the best version of Paul George there is.
Converts in the paint. Nice finish at the rim.
Ed, I have a rule. If you're 6'9 or taller, I don't want to see you jelly it. I don't want to see any kind of weird spin or English on the ball. Just dunk it. Keep it simple, please.
Uh-huh. Nikola Jokic. 3 for 3. That's a perfect start.
He's been doing this for years. The physicality in which he plays. No one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
Beverly to Paul George. That's what you like to see off the pick and roll. Nice, easy basket.
It's easy to become mesmerized when you watch a player who can create off the dribble. We call that dancing. When you allow a player to dance with that much space, that's Prob City.
LA Clippers with the basketball. George doesn't have the touch. No good. Jokic to Will Barton. Short jumper stays out. Ah, Jamal Murray. Right place, right time with the putback.
Sometimes unorthodox, but very crafty on the offensive end of the floor.
George to Beverly. Nikola Jokic rejects it.
That kid can block out the sun, man.
Going to launch beyond the arc. Yes, give the advantage to the shooter.
Even though the coach initially may not like that shot, now he's clapping because that ball went in.
Leonard. To George. The Clippers with 4 to shoot. Paul George fires. Wide open look. Won't go.
Look, sometimes it takes a little while to get into the flow of the game. During the next timeout or during the next break in action, take the ball, go shoot it. See the ball go through the net a couple of times.
Yes, and a foul. He'll have a chance at a 3-point play.
Hey, you ever bail out of something at the last second? That's what I saw right there from the defender. We call that no man's land. They weren't really committed to getting out of the way, committing a hard foul, or taking the brunt of the contact.
Nikola Jokic trying to cash in on a 3-point play. A career 83% free throw shooter. The free throw good. Cashes in on the 3-point play. The lead now stands at 10. Beverly into the front court. Looking to make something happen. Strong finish for Paul George.
And last year, it seemed like PG really had a difficult time finding that next level elite PG. No doubt about it, this year, he needs to be playoff P all day, every day.
Uh-huh. Nikola Jokic, he's now 5 for 6.
I like that aggression early. You never just settle for jumpers. You attack, you attack, you attack. Then when they back off, you'll have room to shoot that, Jay.
And the defender over pursues, and he's called for it.
Welcome to new age basketball. You blow on me, that's a foul.
That's his first personal foul. Team foul number one.
Williams. Has a look. Williams' shot won't go.
The most important thing a shooter can do is continue to shoot. The defense is always going to give great effort, but it's more of your psyche that goes into the next shot that will limit you on whether you make the shot or not.
Beverly into the front court. Down 12 to Paul George. 4-3. Paul George can't get that one to go. Defense all over him.
And look, sometimes you don't have it going every single night. Maybe utilize yourself as a decoy and get some teammates involved with your passing.
Nice pass to set things up.
As a player, there's nothing better than coming out in the first quarter and playing exactly the same way you played the last couple of days of practice. You're moving the ball, you're capitalizing on mistakes, and you really built a nice lead.
Jay Nikola Jokic, he's never made the playoffs, but upon further review, he is a special center.
Got that 5-year extension for $146 million, and I'm willing to say this, he will be one of the future centers in the game.
And count the basket inside.
No doubt about where that one was headed.
Denver ball right now. Layup goes down. Well done.
Well, when you play for each other and not just for yourself, that's when great things happen. You essentially lose yourself in what the team is trying to accomplish. It's called unselfish basketball. And there's nothing more beautiful than rewarding your teammate with a nice pass and letting them finish for 2 or 3 points.
Now whistle. Timeout for Denver as they'll talk things over here in the first quarter. Changes coming from both sides right now. Trying to cash in. Deep two there, won't go. Williams into the front court, trailing by 10. Lou Williams, 2 for 3 now here in the first.
Strong finish, that's what you need, regardless of contact, focusing on the rim.
Lays it up and in.
They're going to have to find answers defensively and quickly because he's carving them up in the first quarter.
Clippers have the basketball. Nikola Jokic swats it. Oh, can't miss those. Nikola Jokic sends it away. That's his third block this evening.
Blocking so many shots only gives your perimeter that much more confidence to really apply more pressure.
Jumper's good.
This has been a good first quarter for him so far. That wasn't an easy shot, but he was able to knock it down and add to their lead.
Nice pass to set things up. Oh, big finish at the rim. They have set the tone in this one.
I love when I see offenses come out in beast mode. You attack that paint, you get to the rim, inevitably the floor will open up for you to knock down some threes.
Williams across the timeline. They can get a 2-for-1 if they play this right. Kawhi Leonard. Jokic is there for the rebound. And look out. Big finish at the rim.
There you go. I like seeing his scoring coming from unlikely sources.
Williams into the front court. Trailing by 14.
They're coming.
Kawhi Leonard. First couple didn't go. That one is true.
When the ball's in his hands, we all knew what was going to happen.
That's off of Leonard, out of bounds. Tough make through traffic.
4-2. The assist from number 27.
Deep three at the buzzer. We played one at Pepsi Center with the Nuggets on top. Jay and I back with more after this. You're watching the NBA on EA Sports. Ed Cohen, Jay Williams with you as we get things started here in the second quarter. It's LA Clippers ball. Leonard to Harkless. Gets to the basket and scores.
As my mother would say to the defender, A for effort, F for results.
Finishing inside the paint on that one.
This type of game needs to be celebrated. This is the type of culture that is fostered when you play with unselfish players. When you give up a little bit of yourself and you make your teammate look great, that's the difference between winning and losing. So when you see these guys smiling, when you see them giving each other high fives, that's because of the energy that was created from the pass. The pass is one of the most brilliant things we have in this game.
Goes reverse to lay it in.
Man, that may not have been a gimme, but that layup at the rim definitely chips away at the pride of the defense.
To Leonard.
Watch that cutter.
Kawhi Leonard, 2-4 now.
You see, you can't actually get mesmerized by the ball. You actually have to focus on the dribbler's belly button. I know that may sound cheesy, but trust me, he can't go anywhere without his core.
Off the mark. What on earth was he thinking? Great feed. Sets it up. Count it.
2 points. Take them any way you can get them.
Goes to the right side. Lets it fly from beyond the arc. Buries it on the catch and shoot.
You know, from a point guard perspective, one of the things that I learned when I played in the league was that the more I was willing to give the ball up, the harder other players were willing to run to their spots. The harder the bigs were running to the rim. The harder the three-point shooters were running to the three-point line because they knew they could be active recipients. And when they caught the ball, they knew exactly what to do with it.
Here's a chance from long range. Won't go down. To Porter. Has a chance, gets it to go. The percentage lied with the defense. Their shooter strikes that time.
Well, they have such great flow to their offense this evening. The ball isn't sticking to one player individually. It's moving around the perimeter, and it's zipping. They're playing with a special cohesiveness.
And a whistle.
A simple touch foul.
Number three. That's his first personal foul.
Both coaches dipping into their reserves. Changes coming onto the floor. George gets it to go. Coach cannot be happy with that closeout.
I know the refs on the court all the time, but it doesn't mean they can see every play. Maybe defensively, grab his jersey, step on his toe, do something to kind of change up his pace.
Oh, good offense beating good defense.
For average shooters, that's not a great shot. But for a great shooter, that's a good look.
Paul George, they'll get it down to Leonard. Kawhi Leonard, 4 out of 7.
And sometimes less is more. Keeping it simple is the best way.
To Millsap. Has a look. And he drains it.
When I played and I see guys do this all the time, when you shoot, the target isn't the basket. The target is actually before you even go into the shot. The target are your hands defensively. If your hands are down and you give me clear vision towards the bucket, that shot's definitely going up.
Denver's got it to Will Barton. And it's Zubats with the rebound. Beverly into the front court. Trailing by 15, George. Shot from the lane, won't go. To Will Barton. And the rebound taken in by Beverly. And the reward, a couple of shots at the line.
Aggressive play there, but you can't fault the defender for being up in the shooter. You need to contest shots, each and every one of them.
Patrick Beverly, couple of free throws on the way. For his career, 76% from the line. Goes 2 for 2 at the line.
Subbing in. It's Denver's ball.
Jamal Murray. Tough shot. He hits.
Look, that shot was going up regardless of what the defender was trying to do. That's called a heat check.
Here's Leonard for two. Off the mark. He's made those before, but that was well defended.
I'm not sure that the contest on the shot contributed to the miss, but what it might have done is seep into the confidence of the shooter that the next time he might decide to try to drive to the rim instead of settling for a jump.
Beverly into the front court. His guys down big. To Leonard. Knocks it down from mid-range.
It looks like he's using his ball handling to feel the game out. I know it looks like he's just playing around out there trying to get the fans going. That is true, but he's also finding his rhythm.
The pass taken away by the Clippers. Plenty of contact. The shot no good to Millsap. Lets it fly from long range. No good.
Come on, show me something better than that, baby. It's game time.
Beverly into the front court. Down a bundle.
Watch the cutter, man.
To Leonard. The drive, right to the basket. Runner here, won't go.
And one of the most underrated things in this game is quick lateral speed. Good job by utilizing that speed and taking away the lane.
And he finishes at the rim.
So many concerns about his strength and, more importantly, his durability. But he looks solid on that play.
And the reward, he's going to the line.
Love the fact that the shooter created contact on the upward motion to shoot the basketball. Big time play.
Misses the first. No good. Missed them both. Murray with the basketball. His guys hold a commanding lead. Paul Millsap, he is shooting well. He's made two-thirds of his shots.
This type of game needs to be celebrated. This is the type of culture that is fostered when you play with unselfish players. When you give up a little bit of yourself and you make your teammate look great, that's the difference between winning and losing. So when you see these guys smiling, when you see them giving each other high fives, that's because of the energy that was created from the pass. Pass is one of the most brilliant things we have in this game.
Nuggets have the possession. To Jokic. And the rebound taken in by George. Beverly into the front court. He'll run the offense. Leonard to George. Kawhi Leonard, unbothered by the defense as he drills it.
I don't know what the point of you having a scouting report is if you don't utilize it. You're allowing him to get to positions on the floor where you know he feels most comfortable. Make it a challenge for him by making him do something uncomfortable.
Paul George, that is great vision to set it up. Almost unlucky bounce. Trying to cash in, gets a look, can't hit. Short jumper off the mark. On the follow, way to stay with it. Bad pass there. Clippers have it. Late heave to beat the buzzer. A very one-sided first half of basketball as we are at halftime. Let's get you to Orlando where we say hello to Jalen Rose and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Jalen.
The Nuggets are up. Thanks for joining us for the Halftime Report. The second half is about to get started.
It's the Clippers with the possession now. Leonard to Paul George. Here comes the screen. George, too easy. Defense has to communicate.
I know he's a volume shooter. I know defensively at times you have to take your lumps. Might be time to adjust the scouting report, though. Start denying him the ball.
Murray into the front court. His guys lead here, early stages, third quarter. Count it. No and one. There was some contact there.
I remember my high school coach said one man can't beat five. Well, I'm telling you right now, he lied. I'm watching it happen in person.
The pass taken away by the Clippers to Beverly. And he'll head to the line.
Just because a team's winning doesn't mean the refs are going to put away the whistle. Play right all the way through.
Paul George has got two shots coming. A career 84% free throw shooter. Able to convert on both free throws. Murray with it. His team on top by 13. Beyond the arc for three. Had made his first couple, but he misses there. Beverly into the front court. Looking to make something happen. And Paul George good on the quick release there.
Ed, let me tell you how this one goes. It ain't no fun if the homies can't have some. Everyone's getting a piece of the rock tonight.
To Jokic. From the outside, no good.
The contest was good, but you being a nuisance was great. Continue to be that gnat that no matter how many times you swing at it, it never goes away.
And a putback slam.
Woo, that's nasty right there.
Murray into the front court. His team on top by eight. Has a chance. Just enough of a head fake to help on that one.
This may sound cheesy, but sometimes you just need to sit back, get a tub of popcorn, and just enjoy the show, because that's what you're watching right now.
And a whistle.
Just a tic-tac foul.
To number four, Paul Millsap. That's his second personal foul. Team foul number two.
It's George for two. He had all day and all night to knock that one down. Need to hear more chatter on the defensive end.
Clearly not afraid of the spotlight here, because that was not an easy look.
And countered at the rim.
Oh man, you're not supposed to be able to do that with that size, but in today's game, dexterity and mobility are off the charts for bigs.
To Leonard. Can't connect from in close. Mart into the front court. Lead stands at 10. Yes, and the foul, and a chance at three coming up.
So many times we get on the defender for quote-unquote letting the offensive player score on an and one. Sometimes there's a lucky bounce, but more often than not, it's the offensive player who makes the play happen despite the defender's best intentions.
Free throw up and good as they open things up to a 13-point lead. They call the foul, Jay.
Welcome to New Age basketball. You blow on me, that's a foul.
That's his third personal foul. Team foul number three.
George. Jokic snares the rebound. Martin into the front court. The advantage is 13 points. Count the basket. A lot of contact. No foul.
It's so difficult to block a guy like that with that kind of athleticism and length. Your timing almost has to be perfect, but pretty much there's no stopping him when he's around the rim.
Cash is in. Someone has to get into a zip code.
The one thing we know for certain in this league, it doesn't matter how big the margin is, you can always put together a run and get back in this one.
Short jumper stays out.
It's easy. Force guys into low percentage shots. That's the reason why we're big into stats. It was all provided to you before the game in the scouting report.
Oh, with the foul and a chance coming up at the line.
There's a very fine line between maximum effort and carelessness. I'm willing to live with a few mistakes and maximal effort than having to constantly remind my players to close out.
First try, no good. he missed on a pair. Jamal Murray. Tough shot. Well defended.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
Murray with the basketball. The lead is 11. Stuffs it down with authority.
Sometimes when the players find that flow, nobody else needs to touch the ball. He's in the zone by himself.
George, he was all over him.
And big-time coaching strategy by the staff right there, utilizing their bench, keeping fresh legs on that shooter consistently throughout the course of the game.
Here comes the screen. That's what you like to see off the pick and roll. Nice, easy basket. He's been a one-man show, but Jay, they're still down in this one.
He's their lone bright star, their only star tonight. Some other of the supporting cast members really need to step up.
Deep two there, won't go. Patrick Beverley, he has struggled just a little bit, 2 for 5.
Ooh, cool, calm, and collective. The three C's. His handles are effortless.
Both teams tweaking their lineups. Here come some changes.
I'm here.
Bad pass there. Clippers have it.
You go back to the principles. Things that we started working on when we were in first and second grade is called the shell drill. You stay down in the stance defensively, you try to deny the next pass away, and you have to communicate. If your conditioning is bad, you have no chance. But if you're able to do all these things together, collectively, you'll be able to stop a great passing team.
LA Clippers with the basketball. George to Leonard. He'll get it down low to Harrell. Nikola Jokic with the block. Fourth this contest.
This game is all about playing mind tricks on people. The offense is more worried about getting their shot blocked than they are about actually making the shot.
They're going to make some changes with some new personnel on the floor. Malik Beasley at the line for a chance at a three-point play. For his career, 69% at the line. Count the free throw as well. Williams across the timeline. The deficit now up to 13. Leonard to George. Nikola Jokic tips it. Ooh, 5 now.
You know why? I don't see anybody on the defensive end standing up out of position. I see everybody squatted down, really active with their hands. That's the mentality that will lead you to where you want to go.
Clippers have the basketball. Nikola Jokic with a piece. Incredible. 6 tonight. It's a big finish.
Ah, and that transition offense was flawless. When guys fan out and actually fill the lanes with a sense of urgency, you heard me correctly, a sense of urgency, you will get a great shot every possession.
Substitution being made in this one. Williams to Paul George. Fires the three. Misfires. It's no good. The pass set it all up.
That's a strong finish. Regardless of contact, finishing strong is key.
Here comes the screen. Doesn't have the touch. No good. They'll let one fly from half court. There's the buzzer. Three quarters complete. The Nuggets enjoying a nice cushion. It's the Nuggets with the basketball to start the fourth quarter, and it might be time to empty the bench, Jay. This game appears to be well in hand.
And their starting five has certainly earned the fourth quarter off. They've been terrific this ball game, and this is the type of game where you find a chance to relax. You ice up, you watch your other teammates play, you applaud them, and you get ready for the next game.
And knocks it down.
And watching all these great shooters on the floor once, it almost mesmerizes me. It's like you're watching the shot in slow motion, the backspin. It gives off the feel that the ball's going in every time.
He'll get it down low to Harrell. Turns and slams it down.
See, Ed, that's what I love. You don't need to conserve your energy. You attack that rim with ferocity. You always set the tone.
Layup's good. Those are the types of shots you always strive for.
You know, it reminds me, Ed, of a story a legendary coach once told me. He said, if you ever get in a fight, you're not going to hit somebody with an open hand, correct? You'll probably break a finger. But if you hit somebody with a fist, what is that? That's five fingers working collectively together as one. That's how you deliver a knockout punch, and that's what we're seeing tonight.
Now, he was smothered and still gets it to go down.
Well, we got a chance to firsthand watch something be created. I think we just watched an epidemic of passing. I've never seen something like this before. It was so contagious, everybody started to do it, and it ultimately led to the other team's demise.
If that's an epidemic, sign me up. To Porter. Yes, and a foul. Hell of a chance at a three-point play.
Ed, you ever bail out of something at the last second? That's what I saw right there from the defender. We call that no man's land. They weren't really committed to getting out of the way, committing a hard foul, or taking the brunt of the contact.
Free throws good. Add one more to the total. This game feels out of reach. It's L.A. Clippers ball. To Harkless. Probing the defense. Nikola Jokic. Able to recover with the block. Make that seven.
Here's one of the biggest secrets as we move into this new age of basketball. Especially in the draft room. You have to draft players with size and length. That's the biggest deterrent for any team offensive.
Hold on. Self-check.
Down low to Williams. Lou Williams! Now 4 for 9.
And when the ball gets the defense rotating from side to side, you're bound to find opportunities for each other.
To Jokic. Oh, Jay, he commands the paint this time down.
You know, Ed, I'm down with guys having 35, 40, maybe 50 points in the game. But the one thing you look for in a defensive end, when there's a huddle after a guy has dropped multiple buckets on you in a row, and everybody's quiet, nobody stands up and says, yo, I got him, I'm going to stop him, you're in a worrisome place for your team.
Nuggets with the basketball. Jokic to Porter. Finishing inside the paint on that one. Takes stock of the floor. Williams into the front court. His guy's down big. Wide open look won't go.
Oh, I like that. You got the defense rotating from side to side. They're even recovering late, but still you got to make that one.
Now the Nuggets signaling for timeout as they'll talk things over here in this fourth quarter. Looks like both teams are making substitutions. To Jokic. Has a look. With the fadeaway. Burns him for the basket.
We're watching a clinic right now. We're watching basketball one-on-one. Whoever this professor is, he needs to get paid top dollar.
Leonard to Williams. Beverly. And it's rebounded by the Nuggets. It goes down.
Well, the shooting has been spectacular, but one of the things that I've seen as the difference maker in this ball game is how they are catching the basketball. They're not establishing a pivot foot, which leaves the defense wondering which way you can drive. But when that shot is working like that, you got it any way you want.
Driving right to the basket, unbothered by the defense as he drills it.
I get tired of hearing guys say, I was there, I contested a shot, I pretty much had a hand in his face. Well, no, you have to change up the game. If a guy is right-handed, he is right-eye dominant. Get that hand over his right eye, block his vision, that'll enhance his chances of missing the shot.
It's the Clippers with the possession now. Williams to Leonard. For three, and Lou Williams, he doesn't miss many of those. A wide open look for three.
Oh, I like what you're doing right now. It looks like you're running some DHOs into PNRs. That's dribble handoffs into pick and rolls. You keep running that action, you're constantly going to keep the defense guessing.
Yes, and the foul, and a chance at three coming up.
The defender was actually in a good position there. They even made a decent play on the ball, but sometimes those bounces go the other way. Still, stay aggressive out there.
Jamal Murray trying to cash in on a three-point play for his career, 89%. Free throws good as they continue to widen their lead. Nuggets have the possession. Barton. Paul Millsap looking good. 4 for 5.
Shows like this separate the good players from the great ones. The good players, they have good first halves, and then they fade to black in the second. The great players, they just sustain that kind of dynamic energy throughout the entire ballgame.
And stuffs it home. At this point, they're twisting in the wind.
Were you looking for a response from me? Because I don't really know what else there is to even say. I mean, is this even a game? I mean, we should just start packing up and getting ready to go right now.
Here's Leonard for two. Oh, he was wide open. It's not going to be pretty when they watch the video. Someone's getting chewed out.
I mean, this is something everybody can relate to in their lives. It's happened to me while doing broadcasts as well. Sometimes you're physically there, but mentally you're nowhere to be found. We obviously saw one of those same things happen on the court.
Nikola Jokic pins it. 8 now. Kawhi Leonard, it's good. If you don't stand in his way, he's going to make you pay.
And there's nothing more mentally intimidating for your opponent than when your own teammates are unselfish and make sure that you get the ball because they want you to drop 70 on them, maybe like Devin Booker did last year.
Nikola Jokic at the line for a chance at a three-point play. He's perfect from the line so far. Got it. LA Clippers with the basketball.
Watch the cut. I got the cut. I got the cut. Watch the cut.
Leonard. Nice pass to set things up. Strong finish for Paul George.
I see the easy dunk. But what I don't see is energy. Scream, do something. Get yourself emotionally involved in the game.
Add 2 more points. The defense had him, but the good shooters find a way.
Ed, I have so much admiration for guys that continue to hunt their shot. They're playing the second half like it was the first 5 minutes of the ball game. Those natural-born leaders are guys that will consistently lead your team to the promised land.
Murray into the front court. His guys hold a commanding lead. Trying to cash in, knocks it down from mid-range.
There's something that is so impressive about what we saw this evening. Not just the shot-making ability, but the fact that not every shot came from the pocket. There were some bad passes being made, and the shots came from different places around the body, which aren't usual for the typical shot. That shot-making ability, that's something special to watch.
To Millsap. Cashes in for two.
He's been doing this for years. The physicality in which he plays. No one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
Tough shot and nearly a chance at a three-point play. No foul.
I've seen him float so much on the perimeter, I forgot he even had that kind of physical presence. Good to see him beating up on people down low again.
And he buries it. Timeout called here by the Clippers. They're down big in this fourth quarter and a chance here to empty their bench. Opposing coach is going to counter, make some changes of his own. That misses with 3 seconds left. It's the Nuggets who come away victorious as they win this one in blowout fashion. That does it. For my partner, Jay Williams, and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been a presentation of the NBA on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. As we say, so long, everyone.